proposed appraisal is here to speak.
Yes, if you would give that to me.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Yeah.
Can you give me a brief overview of how you come up with this assessment here? Where did you look at, in what area?
So we've been looking at this question for about 15 years. We've been looking globally in the southeast, but we've worked about 28 states in the soil farms. At the time, we've looked at over 1,000 soil farms, primarily like Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, Tennessee, what we're doing is we're just looking for sales and properties next to soil farms. So we can just look at that, compare it to similar homes that are sold nearby that are not as a soil farm. So we can just look to see if there's anything there to measure as far as the impact goes. It's called impaired sales analysis. It's what the appraisal institute puts forward as the least way of looking for damages. And we find the results from that, we find some examples where we do find some negative impacts. We also find some that show positive impacts. About 7% of the data we've got, we've got over 100 max territories. About 7% show negative impacts. About 15% show positive impacts. The rest of the other, like 78%, shows neutral to no impacts at all. So, again, if you look at this on a static chart, it's all simply black on zero. So, that's what we're looking at when we do that. But we've also done a number of other ways. We've interviewed assessors in all different states, including Georgia, where we just asked them, do you make adjustments for anything next to soil farm? We've got 77 responses back from assessors across multiple states. So far, we've got zero assessors who didn't make any negative adjustments for farms next to soil farms. And the other sources that we look at, there's major university studies that go into this. There's the University of Texas at Austin. They did a survey of appraisers and assessors across the country. And the conclusion of that study was that there was actually no impact or mild positive impact was what they got from that. They did have some responses in that study that showed significant negative impacts. But one of the questions they asked in that survey is, have you ever actually appraised something next to a solar farm? And when they exclude the appraisers who say, I've never appraised anything next to a solar farm, but I've guessed that number. When they exclude that, they find the impacts all went from about -5 to about +10%. And that -5% is if you're 100 feet away from 100 megawatt to a solar farm, with no landscape. So,
no landscape.
So that's where that comes from. The next university study that is often cited is on Rhode Island. That one gets cited a lot because the abstract says we found a negative impact. But it's in the details. If you read the report, they found negative impacts in urban areas. In 80% of the data they looked at, in rural areas, they have an impact. In rural areas, 500 people per square mile or less. They even did a sensitivity test. When they moved that up to about 2,000 people per square mile, got really the most urban areas. And they still found impact. So again, the population density in this township is significantly lower than that 500 mark. So again, the Rhode Island study supports the 500 no impact. The final ones out are actually Georgia Tech. They studied farming across North Carolina. And after solar farms installed, they found no negative impact on farmland values, but they did find a mild positive impact on farmland along the exact same values based on the consumption that people are seeing like potential for the
growth.
So that's the basis for our final on that. We've got, I can go into more detail, but that's the simplest way to sum up all the data.
Thank you.
I have a question on that. Now, today, do you ask our tax assessor, do you give the county tax assessor to find if there's any negative impact on
what we did was we surveyed all the assessors in Georgia. We sent out a questionnaire. I don't recall if I have a specific response from Brooks County. Mm-hmm. We only have 5 responses in Georgia right now. So most of the responses we have are actually in Virginia and Alabama.
All right. You said you've been doing this for 15 years.
Yes, sir.
So you've been working with solar companies for 15 years?
Yes.
On this?
Yeah, different companies, yes.
Different solar companies.
I've also been hired by local government to do research on this.
Could we get Mr. Wayne up here to talk if there's any negative impact in the county with our solar projects? Isn't there?
Who?
Mr. Wallen? Hi. Wayne?
Is Wayne Wallen here?
Yeah, I can barely hear.
So, do you have any comments? Sorry, Wayne.
And did you get the questionnaire from us?
Could you come on, Wayne?
Mike, could you come up?